Good morning, students of class 9. You are welcome back to the online portal now. Let's continue our lesson in history. We are doing economy and society 2.2 from French Revolution, and we are doing socialism in Russia. Now here, economy and society. In our previous class, we have learned about the economy of the towns. Most of the people were employed in industries, and these people, they were categorized according to their skills and talents. So similarly, now we'll talk about the economy and society of the villages or countryside. Now here, number one, in the countryside, peasants cultivated most of the lands. In the countryside, the peasants, the villagers, they cultivated most of the lands, especially those lands owned by the landlords. These peasants were mostly landless laborers, farm laborers. So they cultivated most of the land, but the nobility and the crown, crown means the king and his relatives, the nobility and the crown and the Orthodox Church, you can see the clergy, the priest, Orthodox Church owned large properties. They owned large plots of land in the countryside, and these peasants, they used to work there. Most of the peasants were poor and landless. They were farm laborers. So now you can see there, number two, like workers in industrial towns, like factory workers in industries in towns, peasants too were divided and deeply religious. The peasants were also divided. Social division was there, and they were also very deeply religious. They were quite orthodox. So now, they had no respect. Now, what we are learning over here is the difference between the French peasants and the Russian peasants. We'll see the difference now. Here, they had no respect for nobility in Russia. In Russia, the peasants had no respect for nobility, as they get their power and position through the Tsar government. The Tsar Nicholas was the emperor of Russia, and these nobilities, they got the power and position through the government and not through local popularity. The people did not like these nobilities because they were quite harsh and they were quite cruel, and they exhorted heavy taxes, they charged heavy taxes. So in this way, people did not like these nobilities. They were not popular among the local people or peasants. That's why they did not like and they did not respect for the nobilities in Russia. This was not like France. You see, in France it was not like this. This was not like France, where during French Revolution, peasants respected nobles and fought for them. You can see the difference over here. In France, during French Revolution, peasants supported the nobles and even they fought for them. But here in Russia, they had no respect for the nobilities, as they were harsh, cruel, and because these nobilities got the power and position from the Tsar government. But in France, these nobilities, they got the power and position from the people, because people liked them. They were very much popular among the people. That's why they supported them, respected them, and even fought for them. Here, number five, in Russia, In Russia, peasants wanted the land of the nobles to be given to them. In Russia, the peasants wanted that the land owned by the nobles, clergies, and the church should be provided to the local people. They wanted to have that land. It should be given to them. They refused to pay rent. The peasants in Russia, they refused to pay the rent and even murdered the landlords. There was wide-scale murders of the landlords because they wanted the land of the landlords for them. So now you can see, in 1902, this occurred. This means murdering of the landlords. In 1902, this occurred on a large scale in South Russia. In South Russia, large-scale murders took place. So, most of the landlords, most of the clergies, and the relatives of the kings who owned properties, they were murdered. So, this type of event occurred on a large scale in South Russia. And in 1905, this event spread all over Russia. In 1905, such incidents, such happenings took place all over Russia. That means the nobility's landlords were scared. They had to run away in order to save their lives. And their lands were taken over by the peasants. So, in this way, Russian peasants were different. Russian peasants were different in other ways also. This is the one difference. In other ways, these Russian peasants were different because they, these peasants, combined their small land holdings and they did the farming and shared the profit equally, which we cannot find in or see in French Revolution or in France. This type of event or incident did not took place in France. But in Russia, most of the landlords were murdered because they wanted to have their lands. Peasants wanted to have the lands. And in, as well as these peasants, they combined their, consolidated their land holdings and did the farming and shared the profit equally. These things, it did not happen in France. So these were the differences we can see between the peasants of France and between the peasants of Russia. Between France and Russia, the peasants were quite different. Economy and society we were talking about. So in our next class, we will talk about something more. Not this, we'll have 2.3. We'll go to 2.3 and we'll talk about that. So that's all for today. Thank you very much for watching show attentively. And you have listened so attentively and paid attention so much. So thank you very much. And we'll meet in the next class and continue our lesson in 2.3. So that's all for today. Thank you very much.